technology of surgery itself has developed, because these organs are not enough to save these patients suffering from like the diseases that have an effect on these organs, we see many patients suffering. So today, we propose this motion to use these financial incentives to increase the donations of organs. And now let's go on to the definition. And we will take this proposal in all liberal democratic countries. And when we say use financial incentives, well, first of all, the government will make an organization that controls the flow of the money and the flow of these organs. So, and the government would be regularly checking this organization, making sure that they're not doing this illegal, bad, selling, buying stuff. And the price will be set by the organ, by the government. And we have three conditions today. One is about that the donors would have to be above a certain age, and we would set this age as like an age of adulthood for each country, because we think that only adults can perfectly understand what's happening to them, and so we can, by taking this age set, then we can prevent like children from being forced to sell their organs or stuff like that. And the second condition is that these people would have to go under this medical checkup, make sure that their organs are healthy. And so when the doctor says, yes, you can sell this organ because you're healthy enough, then they can sell it. And the organs that can be sold are only limited to those, like such as liver or kidney, where the donors can survive even after the organ, even after they have their organs taken out. And the third condition is that they will have to be fully informed by their doctors. Fully informed means like they have to know about what will happen, the possibility of the restrictions of like food or exercise they might have after they have take out their organs. So they have to be fully informed by the doctors, and they have to give this consent that yes, I truly understand. And so that is our three conditions we have today. And I like to talk about 2 points. The first one about the body autonomy, how these people have freedom to choose, a freedom to use their body however they want. And the second is about how practically the patients who are suffering right now will be saved. And the third point my partner will talk about. Now let's go one by one. So the first point about this body autonomy. We think that the people, they have 100% control of their own body, the body they are born with, unless you cause harm to others. Like, for example, if you like commit murder with your hand, then that's not okay. But as long as you don't harm others, then we think that people have the right to use their body however they want. Like, for example, mining. Even though it's dangerous, people are allowed to do that if they understand the conditions they're in. And we say that organ donation is one way to use their body for their own benefit. So it's like it's similar to mining as well. And also we have another example, which is like clinical tests.
Okay.
No. Clinical tests is where like people get money, and because they allow these like researchers to test on an unknown drug on their body. And clinical tests is also done for money as well. So we say that this example can be applied to today's case of donation of organs as well. And so even if the action they take have a direct physical harm to themselves, if they understand it, we think that these people have the right to do it, take this action. And so we think that these people have the freedom to do whatever they want, to do with their body, as long as it doesn't harm others, and as long as they understand the consequences of their own actions. And we think that today, because we're going to fully inform these patients of the possibility of future restrictions and things, we think that they are fully informed and they have the right to use their body. And, well, the opposition might say that, like, well, even if it's fully informed, they might be blinded by this money or something. But we say that, like, first of all, these perfect contracts never exist. And like, for example, like the Batista surgery, where like they have a heart surgery, the possibility of succeeding is very low. But people are still allowed to do it because they are given the maximum amount of information that exists under the status quo, and they understand the possibilities of possibility of the consequences, and they give consent to it. So in this way, we say that today's condition of fully informing is enough for these people to give consent and allow them to take action with their body. And so this is our justification today, that these people have the freedom to use their bodies. And now going on to the second point, which is about how practically this can save the patients who are suffering right now. So under the status quo, as I said in my introduction, there's many people waiting in line to get these organ transplants. They got diseases, and their organ is like infunctioning right now, and so they are suffering, but they can't get these organ transplants because there are just not enough donors. We say that the donors are not enough right now because it's truly based on these donors' goodwill. Like, for example, in the case of Japan, the donors only get, like, a piece of letter coming from the minister saying, oh, thank you, or something, a letter of appreciation. That's all they get. Yes?
What about another status quo by the doing the dialysis or something like that? Actually, without giving the donation of the organ, actually, to some extent, we can cure this disease. Why uniquely the donation and
yes.
incentive?
Well, we think that organ is a very complex function that works within their body. So the organ, the whole organ is needed to save these patients, save these people from diseases they have gone through. And so, well, going back to the point, so under the status quo, it's truly based on their goodwill, and we think that that is not incentivized enough. So after the plan, by giving out these payments of like financial incentives, this will be a visible reward that can be seen by the donors. And by this, the people will be incentivized to donate because they will be paid for the risks they'll be taking. And so because these people will be incentivized, the number of donors, the organs will increase, the number of organs available for transplant will increase. The patients who are suffering right now, waiting in line, can be saved as well. And this is very important because we say that the people are suffering now. The opposition might say, like, the technology is improving, so it will be okay by keeping the status quo. But we cannot wait for 50 years to get this technology going up. We need to save the patients now. And we say that this proposal is uniquely the only way to save the patients now, so we strongly propose this motion today. Thank you.
Thanks to Prime Minister for her speech. And now I call upon the leader of the opposition to open up the opposition's case within a 7-minute constructive speech.
Can't accept this. And secondly, my partner explained, unsuccessful technology has improved. This is quite unsuccessful. People who need kidney can't survive thanks to technology. Now, let's go to my first argument. So, I want to talk about why governments have the right, have duty to protect citizens. Basically, I have two reasons. Firstly, because in many cases, sometimes citizens cannot make sensible choice because they are sometimes optimistic. They overestimate benefits and they underestimate risk. For example, this is why governments force every citizen to wear seatbelt regardless of your age. Because in many cases, people who understand car accidents is very, very dangerous. However, since they're optimistic, they don't try to wear seatbelt by themselves. This is why, in this case, governments have to intervene here and protect them. And secondly, we also believe that considering the economic gap between poor people and rich people after taking the proposal, exploitation will occur. What does it mean? Because it's obvious that poor people have to be economically forced to sell their organs because they actually need money. And we believe this kind of exploitation should be prevented. This is why, as a statistical percent, government establish labor rules because we need to prevent rich employers completely exploit poor workers. And we think that's a good thing. And the proposed updating proposal said it's obvious that more and more self people have to sell their own body and rich people receive just their own. I think this is pretty much exploitation by rich and poor. Therefore, we need to prevent this point. Now, let's go on to my second argument. So, I want to talk about how, after taking proposal, poor people will suffer.
Well, we are not talking about the exploitation from the mafia or so. We are talking about the choice based on their will after enough information from the government, don't you think so?
Well, we don't talk about such kinds of mafia activity. We just say that after taking proposal, what kind of people will more likely to sell their organs? Do you think after taking proposal, rich people try to sell their organs? Of course, they don't know, because they don't need any money. Of course, poor people, only poor people have to sell it, and governments create this situation. This is why we need to ban it. Now, let's go on to my second argument. Thank you. Firstly, we want to talk about whether or not the brand value is beneficial to our poor people. We believe under SASCO, governments do their best because they give job opportunity by hello work, etc., and they also give job training for needs. And if job training is not enough, then we should increase job training and we should promote job training. There is no reason why we need to give choice for people to sell their body. Now, and after taking proposal, what will happen? We believe, firstly, we don't think that they can use enormous money in a sensible way after taking proposal. Because we need to understand why poor people are poor and the status quo. Because they may not study hard when they are young, or they may use money as they wish. This is why, basically, poor people are not use money in a practical way, in a sensible way. This is why the sample they are poor. And even if we take proposal, still the character of poor people will not change. Still, they are less inclined to use money. This is why nothing. We don't think after taking proposal that poor people will use money in a sensible way. They choose. This is why we don't say actually these kind of people. And secondly, even if poor people use money in a sensible way and try to get jobs, still situation will change because basically it was difficult for them to get jobs once they sell organs. Because I want ask because employers want to hire healthy people, and even though we take proposal, actually there are a lot of competitors who are healthy and who get job training. This is why a person who sells their organ will less likely to get job and less likely to get rid of poverty. Actually, we don't change any situation. Poor people will suffer much more by taking proposal. So what we want to talk about, firstly, under that goal, government is the best, government gives opportunity, and they also promote donation by using donor account, etc. They do the best. And secondly, actually, exploitation by poor is never be justified. Government have to do that. Therefore, we back the court. Thank you.
I thank the leader of the opposition for his speech. And to continue the debate, I invite the DP Prime Minister.
Majority of the people waiting for transplant is not the heart, but waiting for liver and kidney. We say that in order to save those people who are desperate need those kind of organs, by taking this plan, we can see the clear benefits that those people will be saved. And also, it will diminish the black market, which are actually exploiting the donators, another set of recipients, another set of goals. So we say we have to take this plan right now. So firstly, let me do the couple of presentations to the leader of the opposition. Firstly, paternalism analysis. He has talked about that people cannot make rationally, cannot make decisions rationally. So government has to intervene, but we say it is not true. He has given you one single example about the seatbelt rule, but it is actually not true. Why we have to enforce the seatbelt rule is because by doing so, without wearing the seatbelt, it is high risk that people will collide with each other, bump to the other cars, and it will harm others. So it is not why the seatbelt rule is being applied is because it harms others. So that we say, our stance clearly stands because as long as it doesn't harm others, people have to respect their own decision by themselves, respect their decision making. That is why we are allowing the smoking or bungee jumping or boxing, which also risks their life and which also include the people who cannot think rationally, but we are allowing those kind of choices because under the democratic society, we are respecting their own decision making as long as the harm stays within themselves. So the argument paternalism doesn't stand. So secondly, he has talked about poor people's health will be ruined. But we say we have to clarify what kind of people will be donating. We say that extremely poor people, such as Nekafe refugee or Halowak, people who are homeless people, will be screened out from the process of evaluating the quality of the organs, because those kinds of people's organs face malnutrition or lack of nutrition, so that those people's organs will be screened out from the beginning of the process of to check the quality of the organ. So what kind of people are actually will be donating is that relatively poor people below the median income, so that those people will sell it, and they will calculate the benefits, the economical benefits they can get from doing the donation, and the body risk from long-term perspective, and then some people will sell it. So that even if there are some minor risks that they will face in the future, but those people have decided that they will take that risk, prioritize the economical benefit to the long-term risk, so that it is okay, because we are rather respecting those people's choices. And we say without having that money, going to the school or getting that enough education is more difficult for those relatively poor people. That is the reason why those poor people decide to donate their organs. That is okay, yes.
If you exclude poor people who donate after taking this proposal. However, who will be attracted by this incentive or a financial incentive?
No, we are talking about, we are dividing the poor people from the, firstly, extremely poor people who are homeless and so forth, and relatively poor people below the median income. And we are targeting on the latter part, so their argument, their recession doesn't start. So moving on to reconstruction of my partner's tips. He has repeated on our second point that poor people don't have enough education, so the perfect understanding contract will not be occur. But this it is not true, because doctors have an obligation to tell the patient inform duty. So the doctors will do their best for patients to understand fully by sacrificing their time. So the patients also can ask what kind of risk they will face during the informed consent. So that patients will, their simplistic analysis of patients will not understand at all, do not exist, because doctors will take enough care of the patient when he does the informed consent. And also it is not an exception, because other medical surgery also needs an informed consent, and patients agree to that informed consent, and then they will take a medical surgery. Why we have to, why the only the organ donation should be in exceptional cases that the patient cannot understand? There's a burden of proof from the opposition bench. So moving on to our third point, which is about it will diminish the black market. As my partner clearly mentioned, that we are facing a severe organ shortage, and also the donator is on the waiting list and desperate need organs. The opposition side says dialysis is okay, but if you think about the patients who are taking the dialysis for 20 years, it is painful so much that those patients want to get away with harsh situations right now. So people only think about the immediate pleasure. That in that at that time period, black market people or people who are doing the business under the black market people, you given optimal choices, so that by saying that by taking the procedures which are taken in the black market, those people you will be safe. And so that is why there are some people or many people who are desperately need the organ transplant and go to the black market. And it is also risky, but those risky will be undermined, and then they go to the black market. But what will happen? What is happening under the black market? Because bad environment, firstly, because unskillful doctor has a bad operation, and who doesn't get enough certificate, and secondly, no informed consent, and thirdly, insanity, because medical appliances is very contaminated, so the patient's body is being contaminated and ruined. And secondly, exploited financially, because there are no proper kind of negotiations, informed consent is occurring under the black market, so patients are in the weak position, so that the patient also financially exploited. But by taking this down, what will happen? Because we will have the black market and the legal market, so the many patients will shift to go to the black market from the black market to the legal market, because they don't want to put an unnecessary risk, money or body, so that patient's body will be safe under the skillful doctor, enough informed consent and sanity places, so that it will see the clear benefit for the patient. We beg to propose. Thank you.
I thank the Deputy Prime Minister for his remarks, and now I invite the Deputy Leader of the Opposition.
Because kidney is what is necessary for your health, and
motion today. Now, have the said, no, let me repeat what the government side has said. They said first that because doctor was well informed, about the danger of the organ transplant the donation of organs, there is no problem that the people would just exercise their body autonomy and sell organs. But that is not true. Why? Because even if the doctors well informed about people about those kind of dangers, because it is a difficult thing for them to understand. Because first of all, as my partner has clearly analyzed, yeah, these people are poor, and if we assume that poor people would sell organs, those people are poor and still not have enough education, and that means that they cannot understand the medical the difficult medical effect on their body. No, thank you. And moreover, because for those poor people, when we assume that they would need an organ, they need the money, and that means that they cannot think about the long-term effect on their body. Even if they're well informed about the long-term possible harm, they cannot think about, oh, it might happen, but I don't care because I want the money right now. And that ends because when we sell the organs, they will get enough money, and that means that they will just sell the organs regardless of the danger, information of danger. So there are and that is why we strongly telling you that the government has the duty to prevent them from doing the irrational sale of the organ, and that's why we strongly believe that the argument does not stand. And moreover, they said that if they take this notion, the black market would be diminished, and that is good. But that is not true. Why? Because even after the plan, the black market would just remain. Why? Because as they have clearly analyzed, the extremely poor people will be kicked out from this from the medical check, and that means that those extremely poor people, because they are the ones who need the money right now, who need the money even a little. They have even a little money. Even they get exploited by the mafia or so. They need the money to live this day, and that means that what would they have? What would they do? And they would go to the even illegal market where there's exploitation, or even there's a bad environment. Yeah. They would go to the black market, and that means that the people who go to the black market under student school would just go to black market even after the plan, and their third argument does not stand. Now I want to move on to the reconstruction of my partner's argument. And he said that if we take this motion, just poor people would go to the donation of organs, and that is problematic. And that is problematic because it is the just exploitation of poor by the rich people. Now I want to reconstruct this point from how the difference between poor and rich people would just strongly oppose this motion today. Thank you.
I thank the deputy leader of the opposition for her speech, and now I invite the whip speaker from the government bench to deliver a 7-minute whip speech.
We said that somehow they say that in the case of the
your cutting your face is okay, because this is based on the choice. But also the LASIK, LASIK is about the surgery about your eyes. But also the even negative euthanasia is also admitted in all of the liberal democratic. We say this kind of the thing is admitted because this is based on the your will. And this is not we said that only yourself, you know that which is the best choice for yourself. We say that the today's case, the organ donation is also the same because this is about your body and also the negative euthanasia, cosmetic surgery, the racist is the same thing about the today's case. That's why we say that the body autonomy in this case is also should be admitted as well as those from the other cases. Don't you think so?
No. Because basic cases or cosmetic surgery case is irrelevant to the financial incentive to...
No, we are talking about body autonomy, and I like to talk about the free... also the state case can be applied because of the free informed case. Well, they say that the perfect, the negative side, the assumption they have is that the full perfect information, perfect understanding is necessary to take action. Well, this is not true. We say that to take action, the perfect understanding is not necessary. Enough understanding is enough. We say that, for example, the driving. I have a driving license, and I don't know the all possibilities, what can be happened in the driving and so on, what kind of accident can be happened. However, I can drive because when I get driving license, I get the register and I get the information from the government to information. So we said that not perfect, perfect is not necessary. Rather, enough information is necessary. And also, as we define what kind of the consequence can be expected or what kind of the disease can be expected, this kind of information which is enough is already told by the government. We said that this is enough. And that is why we said that today's case is based on their will and based on the true information. That's why we say that this is not the case that the government government should avoid. What I want to say that even if some of the patients can get sick after using this proposal, well, this is not the government's responsibility, rather the patient's responsibility, because the government do everything can done. Which means the government should do this because to maximize the patient's health or the maximize the respect the will of the donors. We like to strongly propose this model. Thank you.
I thank the government whip, and now I invite the opposition's whip to whip the government within 7 minutes.
Legalized, as long as it's not harm to others or so forth. However, really don't think so, because we have three reasons. First is about the information and informing is not enough, and second is about choice which direct harm body should not be allowed, and third is about exploitation. And let me summarize one by one. First, actually today the round consensus is about who will engage the donate organ. Actually the round consensus is that after taking this proposal, actually poorer people engage the donating organs. Because these plans don't affect the middle and rich, because middle and rich have enough money to sustain their life, this financial incentive is not workable if we take this proposal for these middle and rich people. That's why the after taking this proposal, just poor people engage this. And that's why the Let me move on the first reason is about the information. Actually, poor cannot understand even if they get the information or so forth. And furthermore, Deputy Prime Minister has talked about other medical treatment is also the same thing if they inform it's okay all kinds of the medical treatment also. However, we don't think so. Because please imagine the case of the blood transfusion cases, and in some countries some blood types is not enough. However, actually no government allow this monetary incentive to increase the blood transfusion or so forth like this, because monetary transfusion is not important at all and should not go to the is not way to go. And that's why actually if we give the information, actually there are some kind of the exception, it's not enough, and actually we should not allow this choice. And second reason is about choice which a direct harm body should not be allowed. And actually my personal clearly told you that since this case is actually government has the right to intervene. No, thank you. And on the other hand, Deputy Prime Minister and harm is, which means that the situation case is just to protect the harm to adult cases or so forth. However, we don't think so, because harm to adult principle is irrelevant to these issues. Because why uniquely government intervene? Because government wants to protect the driver's license if accidents happen or so forth. Furthermore, we say that drug cases or so forth, actually it's not harm to others. However, actually if some people optimistically use the drug, their harm to their body is so very huge. Actually, in order to protect these kinds of huge damages, actually government intervene to not to use the drugs or so forth. No, thank you. And the third reason is about exploitation. Actually, it is a forced choice for the poor, because poor don't have money. In order to sustain their life, poor might engage in the selling of the organs or so forth. So from three reasons, this this choice should not be allowed. Don't you think so, Madam?
Well, if you say that the poor can get money, then why cannot they use the money to like get education, go to school with that money or something, and gain long-term benefits?
Thank you. However, actually, poor have a lot of the incentive to not to go to the school or so forth, because they must go to work or so forth. And actually, even if they go to the education, however, actually they must absent not to pay the tuition or so forth.
Sir.
No, thank you. That's why the poor does not stand. Then let's move on to the second criteria. Poor lose the health or not. Actually, this is a clear harm from the opposition bench. If we take this proposal, actually, poor go to engage the donating organ and they lose the health or so forth. And
sure,
no, thank you. Please imagine the case of the kidney cases. Under the status quo, every person has mainly the healthy people have two kidneys. And if one kidney breaking and gets the damages by the disease or so forth, because of the other kidney, actually we can sustain their life under the status quo. On the other hand, if we take this proposal, just lose one kidney, just remain one kidney. If this one kidney breaks, there is no alternative way to recover their health. That's it. More and more poor will be the patients who won't choose the donating if we take this proposal more and more. That's the patients also will increase after taking this proposal. As a result, they lose the health, nothing. And they cannot get the job, my partner clearly told you, because companies want to hire healthy people or so forth. From these reasons, poor health damage is so serious, and actually we should not take this proposal. The last criteria was black market cases. Somehow, after taking this proposal, black market should be shrink. However, we don't think so, because firstly, status quo is not a problem about the black market because police crack down and nobody wants to get this dangerous organ. That's why there is no demand to get organs through black market under the status quo. That status quo is also is not important. And second is about, after taking this proposal, just poor people who engage black market, extremely poor and not healthy or so forth. That's why if we take this proposal, because of the health checking, they cannot go to the legal and public the donating system or so forth. That's why they cannot shift from the black market to the public donating or so forth. That's why actually black market will remain, even if there is some kind of the black market under the status quo, even if. And furthermore, if we take this proposal, black market also has the incentive to pay the more money rather than the public organization or so forth. From this reason, even if there's a black market exists, however, after taking this proposal, we cannot solve it. From three reasons, we beg to oppose this motion. Thank you.
Thank the opposition's whip, and now I'll call upon the reply speaker from the opposition bench to sum up the case for the opposition bench.
Ladies and gentlemen, please comment that this up. Since people come a little bit understand the consequence, basically, this is why they have a right to use the body as their wish. However, still, government has to care about particularly weak people. This is why sometimes they use affirmative action so that they protect them. And sometimes governments have to also protect them even by restricting their choice. And for considering this point, I'd like to summarize around that. Firstly, I want to talk about principal level of legitimacy. And secondly, I want to talk about how the society will change. Is it beneficial for donors and for recipients? Now, let's go on to my first criteria. Say, firstly, we want to talk about whether or not a person can make rational decisions. This government says that since doctors will do best, and since the institution will be killed, therefore people will make rational decisions. However, they fail to analyze what kind of people will more likely to sell organs. On the other hand, our opposition says that basically, these people are poor people, and firstly because, since their lack of education background, it may find difficult to understand difficult medical terms. However, more importantly, we also analyze why poor people are poor under that school. Simply because poor people are poor because they overestimate the short-term benefit and underestimate the long-term cost. This is why they are suffering from poverty and stuff. And even though we take proposal, this situation will not change, still, they will highly motivate to get money because they overestimate short-term benefit, as my partner mentioned. This is why, even though doctors try to explain again and again, these people just sell their organs to get short-term benefit. And secondly, this is why in this context we don't view these people can make insensible choice, therefore governments have to protect them. And secondly, we want to talk about whether or not this practice is dangerous or not. This government says that thanks to technology, we can minimize the danger. However, we believe this is still dangerous even though technology is banned. As we speaker mentioned, firstly because it just cuts off your body and remove your organ. However, secondly because if you get disease in the future or you break your the only kidney in the future, then your health will severely undermine. Actually, in the long term, this will severely undermine your health. Therefore, this dangerous activity should be banned to protect citizens. And thirdly, I want to talk about whether or not this practice is exploitation by rich or poor people. This comment says that this is not exploitation because poor people have a right to sell their body. However, actually, government sometimes have a duty to protect certain people even by restricting their choice. For example, this is why government established labor laws as we found some people work hard because we need to protect them. We need to protect them, even though they overestimate economic benefits. And concerning the price rate, it's obvious that more and more people have highly motivated to sell their organs. This is why rich people will buy and some people sell. This is the structure of exploitation. Therefore, in this case, governments have to ban this situation. Now, finally, I want to talk about practical benefit of the plant. Well, whether or not, we want to talk about 2 points. First, how many people will sell their organs, and what kind of kidney, what kind of organ we can get. This government says that only middle-class people will sell their organs, but I want to say that if middle-class poor people can survive under that goal, how many middle-class people will so much value to their organs? And secondly, they also say that doctors will be well-informed. However, if middle-class poor people fully understand the risk, how many middle-class people will sell organs? They don't explain. And thirdly, what kind of organ will be provided? Because we're talking about only kidney and liver. When it comes to kidney, thanks to dialysis, we can project them. And when it comes to this is what I'm saying, we do best. There's no reason we propose that. Thank you.
I thank the opposition's reply speaker and I call upon the government's reply to conclude this round with a 4-minute speech.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Throughout this debate, we can still clearly see the net benefit that recipients who are desperate need the organ transplantation will be saved. So we say we beg to propose trade plan. So today we have 3 crash points. Firstly, about paternalistic or body autonomy, which should be respected. And secondly, patients or recipients benefit. And thirdly, donors benefit. So moving on to that issue one by one. So, moving on to the first issue, body autonomy or paternalism. The reason why we have the government intervene, which was pointed out from the opposition bench, was that, firstly, because there are not enough informed consent, because all the doctors will use a difficult medical term. But we say, firstly, it is not true, as I have repeated, because it is a doctor's obligation to give the patient fully informed until patient understands, easily and orally. So we say that kind of situation never happens. And also, they are optimistically thinking that all the poor people are stupid enough not to understand what kind of medical procedure they will take, but we say it is not true. And also, we have said that other medical procedure is already implemented. For example, blood donation or clinical tests. Maybe it has a possibility that poor and irrational people will go rush to those kind of testing or blood donation, but we are allowing those kind of situation because we are respecting their harm principle, because as long as it does not harm others, as long as it harm stays within themselves, only yourself knows the best thing of your life. So we say we have to respect their choice. And irrationality or rationality should never be used as a criteria in order to ban those kind of body autonomy or paternalistic. So we clearly see we have to respect the patient's decision even throughout this debate. So moving on to the second issue, patients' benefit and recipients' benefit. On our side, clearly saying that there are some people who are desperately need organ transplantation, but we are facing the severe shortage of organs. So there are some people who think about the risk, but those risks will be underestimated, so they are going to the black market. But by taking this plan, because existing illegal market and addition to that, legal markets will appear, so that more. Because people do not want to risk their lives, so we see that more and more people will shift from the illegal market to the legal market. So that at least, under the better environment or a skillful doctor, those patients or recipients will be safe. And what's the reputation from the opposition bench was that diuresis under the status quo is enough, so that patients won't go to the black market, but it is not true. As government whip, my partner has depending on the third issue, donors benefit or not. Opposition side said that poor people will be exploited by donating their organs, succumb to the monetary temptation or so forth. But he has talked, opposition side talked about if the one kidney has lost, you cannot sustain their life, because, but it is not true, because of the proliferation compensation that other kidney will cover their body so they can sustain their life. It is a misanalysis. And also the government side said that by taking this plan, those donors, relatively poor donors, can get money for risks they take. For short term, maybe they have the risk of their body from the minor possibility, but from the long term perspective, they can go to school or get education or get jobs, which they think they thought it is necessary for them to sustain their life. Those people, or relatively poor people, think rationally or by themselves that the long term benefit, economical benefit for themselves, are the risks that they may take for their body, and then they choose to donate their organs. So we have to at least respect their decision. We beg to propose. Thank you.
I thank the government's reply speaker, and now all speeches are over. I thank everybody for the very good model debate, and I call this house closed.